Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to discuss about the difference between string literal and string object. First, string literal. What is a string literal? So a literal is similar to like a primitive data type like int. So in int, how do we declare and assign a value? Int I equal to 10 is an example, right? So in the same way, we declare a string literal as string s1 equal to Java 8. Java 8 is the value assigned to the literal s1. The only thing we need to remember here is string literal should be enclosed in double quotations. So we can also see the literals, examples of the other literals here, s2 equal to program and s3 equal to technology. With this, what happens is a method called intern gets called internally. And what happens with this call is, so we know that when we create an object, right? So some space is occupied in the heap memory. Let's consider this as a heap memory. So in the same way, like we have something called string constant pool for which some space is reserved within the heap memory. And whenever we create a literal, string literal, right? So string s1 equal to Java 8, that will be actually put into the string constant pool if it is not present in the pool already. So in the same way, if the literal is not present in the string constant pool, then the literals are put into the string constant pool, which is within the heap memory. And when we actually declare another literal, which is actually present within the string constant pool, then that the string is already present in the string constant pool, right? So that is returned as the reference to the literal. So this is what we mean by string literal and how it is stored in the string constant pool. Now let's discuss about string object. We know the when we wanted to create an object in Java, right? So we use the keyword new, meaning we are asking JVM to reserve some space, new space on the heap memory. So this is the declaration of the string object, like string s4 equal to new string of the actual content to the string. So this creates a new object on the heap. We can see it here, right? So whenever we wanted to create a new string, another string, right? String object, like same string s5 equal to new string of with the same content. So even though the content matches, we already have the object, but still we are enforcing JVM to create a new object. A new object gets created in the heap memory like this. So these are called the objects. So the main difference we can see here is a string object, whenever you create a new object, right, that object gets created in the heap memory. So even though that content of the string is present within the heap memory, a new object gets created in the heap memory. Whereas in string literal, if the string exists in string constant pool, then that is returned as a reference to the literal. This is the main difference between string literal and object. Now let us write a program and prove this. String s1 equal to Java 8. I'll have another string, s2. I'll assign Java 8 as the value to it. And then we'll create two string objects, new string of, with the same content, Java 8. We'll have the same object created again, s4, with the content of the string as same, Java 8, right? Now, let us actually compare this. S1, S1 is the literal, right? S1 with S2 literal. Whenever we use the assignment operator, it actually verifies the references of the variables, right? So references are the memory locations, memory address. We can say memory address. So we are comparing memory addresses of S1 with S2 here. Next, we'll compare S1 with S3. So we are comparing one literal, S1, with another S3 object. Now we'll compare both objects, S3 and S4. Both are objects, right? So we are going to compare these two. So this is going to return us true if the references of these two objects are same. Otherwise, it returns false. And now S1.equals, we are going to call a method called equals to actually verify the content of the string. So s1.equals s3. This actually compares the content of the string, not the reference, but the content of the string, that is Java 8. So this equals method also returns true if the content is same in both the strings, or else it returns false. Now let us execute this program and check. So we can see here, the first one is S1 equal to S2. So we are actually verifying the two literals, references of the two literals. So as we discussed, literals, when the string already is present, so it actually returns the reference from the string constant pool to the literal. So that's the reason S1 and S2 points to the same reference within the string constant pool. And we can see when we compare the references, it returned true. And when we compare literal S1 with S3, so S1 is a literal and S3 is an object. So we can see it here. Both are refers to the different memory locations. That's why we got false. S3, S4. So both S3 and S4 are objects, though both are objects, both are different objects, are stored in different memory locations on the heap memory. That's the reason when we compare them, we get the value as false. And the last one, we wanted to compare the content of the strings, S1 dot equals S3. Though S1 is a literal and S3 is an object, we are actually trying to compare the content using the equals method. As the content is same in both the strings, we got the value as true. So this is the main difference between the string literal and string object. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.